And we do notice some scattered light rain showers north and south across the plains. They are heading toward the east and slowly but surely will enter our weather picture as well. And they're caused by a cold front that's just off to our west. This approaching front is really fairly weak in nature. It is very fast moving and has limited moisture to work with. That means as it moves across the state, any moisture we see will be very, very light. It'll be in the form of rain because temperatures will be warm enough and probably, a tenth of an inch or less across most areas as that front drifts through.
This is a visible satellite picture from earlier in the day, and what you're seeing in northern Iowa, the remnants of the snowpack up there. Now, this may have some effect on area rivers like the Iowa River, the South Skunk, Raccoon, and Beaver Creek around Grimes later on as this melts.
Most of this is moving off to the east. Look at all that rain through the Ohio Valley and through parts of Tennessee. We've got the area of low pressure moving off to the east, still dragging in the colder air back behind it, and that's why we are starting to see a little bit of a changeover once again from this light rain to some light snow. This system is about to be out of here, though, and we need to start eyeballing our next system. It is already coming into the West Coast, giving rain for Oregon, Washington, northern parts of California.
Here in Portland. Now, the jet stream is taking on more of a winter configuration, moving into the south. The center of the storm and all the cold air is up among the Queen Charlotte Islands, which is fairly a typical place for it. We've got one little system moving through right now that's bringing us the strong showers. You can see it right there. We checked that out on radar. But there's another one back here. That comes in tomorrow for more strong showers and a good chance for a thunderstorm as that gets timed out with the afternoon heating. So, strong storms coming in on Friday, lots of snow in the Cascades.
Our signs of a weather change coming our way. Take a look off to the north and west. There's a cold front up there, and that front is going to push on into the state and will bring us some snow and wind into the mountains for tomorrow. We're going to take you down here to Keystone earlier today, and this is what it looked like looking toward the northwest. You can see those high clouds filtering in.